In this video, we will try to understand how to find out reactions RA and RB in case of a simply supported beam carrying UVL as shown over here and the couple acting over here of 2 kN magnitude, and the couple arm is, this is 1 meter and this is also 1 meter, so total couple arm is 2 meter. So first we'll convert this particular uniformly varying load which is there into a point load acting at the centroid. So first we'll draw this particular UVL which is shown over here of 2 kN per meter magnitude, and the distance for which it is acting is 3 meter. So B is equal to 3 meter and H is equal to 2 kN per meter for this particular triangular distribution or uniformly varying load. Now we'll locate the CG of this particular rectangular, CG of this particular triangular lamina. Now we know that the CG lies at a distance of 2B upon 3 from the apex or from the vertex. Now the total uniformly varying load we can calculate by using the concept of the area of triangle. So this total uniformly varying load will be nothing but the area of this triangle under consideration. And we know that it is nothing but 1/2 base into height. Now the base is 3 meter and the height is 2 kN per meter. These two will get cancelled out. So we'll get the total UVL that will be equal to 3 kN. Now we have to find out what will be the distance of this CG from the apex. And we know that the distance of the CG is nothing but, it is at a distance of 2B upon 3 from the vertex. Now substitute the value of B, that is base, that is 3 meter. Cancel out this 3 from numerator as well as from the denominator. So you'll get 2 meter. So we have calculated the, we have converted the uniformly varying load into point load. The magnitude is 3 kN and it is acting at a distance of 2 meter. Now we'll consider the couple which is acting over here on the beam. So two equal unlike parallel forces, they will form a couple, and the distance between these two forces, that is known as couple arm, is 2 meter. So moment of the couple is given by force multiplied by the couple arm. So force is 2 and distance is also 2, so it is 4 kN meter. So using this we can now draw the loading diagram for this particular beam and we can find out the reactions RA and RB. So we have drawn the line diagram for this beam. The reactions are RA and RB. Then the UVL which we have converted into point load is of magnitude of 3 kN and will be acting at a distance of 2 meter from support A or from point A. This is the moment of 4 kN meter due to the couple. So let us write down the distances over here. So this is of 2 meter. The UVL which we have converted into point load, the distance between CG and point A which we have already calculated over here. Now let us apply the conditions of equilibrium over here. So total span length is 3 plus 3 plus 2, that is total will be 8 meter. So first condition of equilibrium is summation of Fy is equal to 0. Upward forces, they are considered as positive. Downward forces, they are considered as negative. RA and RB, they are positive. Whereas 3 kN force, that is nothing but it is negative. It is acting in the downward direction. So RA plus RB minus 3 is equal to 0, or we can say that Ra plus Rb will be equal to 3 kilonewton. So let us call this as our equation 1. Now we'll apply the another condition of equilibrium, that is summation of moments is equal to 0, clockwise positive and anticlockwise moment is considered as negative. Now this Rb, it will produce anticlockwise moment. So as you can see, arrow of the Rb is going in anticlockwise direction, and this 3 kN, it will produce clockwise moment. So minus Rb, and the perpendicular distance between B and A is 8. Now this 4 kN meter moment is already acting, and it is in the clockwise direction, so that is positive. And this 3 into 2 is a clockwise moment due to the point load. In other words, we can say that this is 4 plus 6, that is 3 into 2 is equal to 8 Rb. So that is 10 is equal to 8 Rb, or we can say that 10 upon 8 will be equal to reaction at point B, and therefore Rb will be equal to 1.25 kilonewton. Now substitute this value in equation 1. So we can substitute over here in this equation 1, that is this particular equation, and we can easily find out the value of Ra from this. So Ra plus Rb is equal to 3, and therefore Ra will be equal to 3 minus Rb, so that is nothing but substitute the value of Rb, that is 1.25, so that will be equal to 1.75 kilonewton. So in this way we can find out the beam reactions